In this video, we are going to talk about how to baby formula is made. Formula. The video will focus on baby formula manufacturing and process. Infant formula, baby formula or just baby formula or baby milk is a manufactured food designed and marketed for feeding to babies and infants under 12 months of age, usually prepared for bottle feeding or cup feeding from powder, mixed with water or liquid, with or without additional water. The U.S. Federal Food, Drug, and Cosmetic Act, FFDCA, defines infant formula as a food which purports to be or is represented for special dietary use solely as a food for infants by reason of its simulation of human milk or its suitability as a complete or partial substitute for human milk. Manufacturers state that the composition of infant formula is designed to be roughly based on a human mother's milk at approximately 1 to 3 months postpartum. However, there are significant differences in the nutrient content of these products. The most commonly used infant formulas contain purified cow's milk whey and casein as a protein source, a blend of vegetable oils as a fat source, lactose as a carbohydrate source, a vitamin mineral mix, and other ingredients depending on the manufacturer. In addition, there are infant formulas using soybean as a protein source in place of cow's milk, mostly in the United States and Great Britain, and formulas using protein hydrolyzed into its component amino acids for infants who are allergic to other proteins. An upswing in breastfeeding in many countries has been accompanied by a deferment in the average age of introduction of baby foods, including cow's milk, resulting in both increased breastfeeding and increased use of infant formula between the ages of 3 and 12 months. A 2001 World Health Organization, WHO, report found that infant formula prepared in accordance with applicable Codex Alimentarius standards was a safe complementary food and a suitable breast milk substitute. In 2003, the WHO and UNICEF published their Global Strategy for Infant and Young Child Feeding, which restated that processed food products for young children should, when sold or otherwise distributed, meet applicable standards recommended by the Codex Alimentarius Commission, and also warned that lack of breastfeeding, and especially lack of exclusive breastfeeding during the first half year of life, are important risk factors for infant and childhood morbidity and mortality. In particular, the use of infant formula in less economically developed countries is linked to poorer health outcomes because of the prevalence of unsanitary preparation conditions, including lack of clean water and lack of sanitizing equipment. A formula-fed child living in unclean conditions is between 6 and 25 times more likely to die of diarrhea and 4 times more likely to die of pneumonia than a breast child. Rarely, use of powdered infant formula, PIF, has been associated with serious illness, and even death, due to infection with Chronobacter sakazaki and other microorganisms that can be introduced to PIF during its production. Although C. sakazaki can cause illness in all age groups, infants are believed to be at greatest risk of infection. Between 1958 and 2006, there have been several dozen reported cases of E. sakazaki infection worldwide. The WHO believes that such infections are underreported. Besides breast milk, infant formula is the only other milk product which the medical community considers nutritionally acceptable for infants under the age of 1 year, as opposed to cow's milk, goat's milk, or follow-on formula. Supplementing with solid food in addition to breast milk or formula begins during weaning, and most babies begin supplementing about the time their first teeth appear, usually around the age of 6 months. Although cow's milk is the basis of almost all infant formula, plain cow's milk is unsuited for infants because of its high casein content and low whey content, and untreated cow's milk is not recommended before the age of 12 months. The infant intestine is not properly equipped to digest non-human milk, and this may often result in diarrhea, intestinal bleeding, and malnutrition. To reduce the negative effect on the infant's digestive system, cow's milk used for formula undergoes processing to be made into infant formula. This includes steps to make protein more easily digestible, and alter the whey to casein protein balance to one closer to human milk, the addition of several essential ingredients, the partial or total replacement of dairy fat with fats of vegetable or marine origin, etc. The nutrient content of infant formula for sale in the United States is regulated by the Food and Drug Administration, FDA, based on recommendations by the American Academy of Pediatrics Committee on Nutrition. The manufacturing process may differ for different types of formula made, therefore, the following is the general procedure for liquid milk-based formulas. Mixing ingredients. Primary ingredients are blended in large stainless steel tanks, and skim milk is added and adjusted to 60 degrees centigrade. Then, fats, oils, and emulsifiers are added. Additional heating and mixing may be required to get proper consistency. Next, minerals, vitamins, and stabilizing gums are added at various points, depending on their sensitivity to heat. The batch is temporarily stored and then transported by pipelines to pasteurization equipment when mixing is complete. Pasteurization. This is a process that protects against spoilage by eliminating bacteria, yeasts, and molds. it involves quickly heating and then cooling of the product under controlled conditions which microorganisms cannot survive. The batch is held at around 85-94 degrees centigrade for approximately 30 seconds, which is necessary to adequately reduce microorganisms and prepare the formula for filling. Homogenization. This is a process which increases emulsion uniformity and stability by reducing size of fat and oil particles in the formula. It is done with a variety of mixing equipment that applies shear to the product, and this mixing breaks fat and oil particles into very small droplets. Standardization. Standardization is used to ensure that the key parameters like pH, fat concentration, and vitamins and mineral content are correct. If insufficient levels of these are found, the batch is reworked to achieve appropriate levels. After this step, the batch is ready to be packaged. Packaging. Packaging depends on manufacturer and type of equipment used, but in general, liquid formula is filled into metal cans with lids crimped into place. Heat treatment or sterilization. Finally, infant formulas are heat treated to maintain the bacteriologic quality of the product. This can be done traditionally by either retort sterilization or high temperature short time (HTST) treatment. Recently, ultra-high temperature treated formula has become more commonly used. If powdered formula is made, then spray drying would be required in addition. Retort sterilization is a traditional retort sterilization method that uses 10 to 15 minutes treatment at 118 degrees centigrade. Ultra-high temperature (UHT) is a method that uses a brief 2-3 seconds treatment at 142 degrees centigrade. Because of the short time used, there is little protein denaturation, but the process still ensures sterility of the final product. Recent and future potential new ingredients. Probiotics. Randomized controlled trials completed in the 2000s have shown limited and short-term clinical benefits for the use of probiotics in infants' diet. The safety of probiotics in general, and in infants, especially preterm infants, has been investigated in a limited number of controlled trials. The findings thus far suggest probiotics are generally safe, though the research is preliminary and has yet to provide definitive conclusions. Prebiotics. Prebiotics are undigestible carbohydrates that promote the growth of probiotic bacteria in the gut. Human milk contains a variety of oligosaccharides believed to be an important factor in the pattern of microflora colonization of breast infants. Because of variety, variability, complexity, and polymorphism of the oligosaccharide composition and structure, it is currently not feasible to reproduce the oligosaccharide components of human milk in a strictly structural fashion. The European Society of Pediatric Gastroenterology, Hepatology, and Nutrition Committee on Nutrition found evidence to support short-term effects of ingesting prebiotics on stool microflora of infants, with increased in the number of bifidobacteria. Babies can be at risk of dehydration with the induction of softer stools if they have the kidney immaturity and or a poor ability to concentrate urine. Reduction of pathogens has been associated with the consumption of prebiotics. However, there was no evidence to support major clinical or long-term benefits. Therefore, there is little evidence of beneficial effects of prebiotics in dietary products. Lysozyme and lactoferrin. Lysozyme is an enzyme that is responsible for protecting the body by damaging bacterial cell walls. Lactoferrin is a globule of multifunctional protein that has antimicrobial activity. Compared to human milk, cow's milk has a significantly lower levels of lysozyme and lactoferrin, therefore, the industry has an increasing interest in adding them into infant formulas. What equipment is needed for infant milk production? Equipment needed for infant milk production are stainless steel tanks, industrial mixer, and heater. Other are pasteurization equipment, homogenization mixing equipment, standardization equipment, labeling, and packaging. Raw materials used in production are fats, carbohydrates, and proteins. What are the main ingredients in baby milk? Typical added ingredients include milk proteins, lactose, soy protein, maltodextrin, and various vitamins and minerals. The selection of raw materials, formulation, manufacturing and storage of baby milk is one of the most stringently regulated in the food industry. The use and marketing of infant formula has come under scrutiny. Breastfeeding, including exclusive breastfeeding for the first 6 months of life, is widely advocated as ideal for babies and infants, both by health authorities and according in ethical advertising of infant formula manufacturers. Despite the recommendation that babies be exclusively breast for the first 6 months, less than 40% of infants below this age are exclusively breast worldwide. The overwhelming majority of American babies are not exclusively breast for this period. In 2005, under 12% of babies were breast exclusively for the first 6 months, with over 60% of babies of 2 months of age being fed formula, and approximately 1 in 4 breast infants having infant formula feeding within 2 days of birth. Some studies have shown that use of formula can vary according to the parent's socioeconomic status, ethnicity, or other characteristics. For example, according to research conducted in Vancouver, Canada, 82% of mothers breastfeed their babies at birth, but the number differed between Caucasians, 91%, and non-Caucasians, 56%, with the difference essentially attributed to marital status, education, and family income.